just what is happening to our weather. It can go from this to this. And it was only a short time back that we even had a period of sweater weather in sunny Singapore. Climate change has made our weather more extreme and unpredictable. I'm meeting Associate Professor Adam Switzer from the Earth Observatory of Singapore to find out why.
Singapore is at the confluence of a number of different climate variables. So we have the monsoon system that we know reasonably well. We have the Indian Ocean Dipole in the Indian Ocean. And then we have the ENSO system, El Nino and La Nina. So that confluence means that our weather patterns here are quite complicated. It's been wetter here, probably mostly driven by La Nina. And as we move out of La Nina, maybe into an El Nino phase, we can expect that much of Southeast Asia will be drier and considerably warmer.
El Nino and La Nina are opposite phases of the El Nino Southern Oscillation, or ENSO. They occur in a cycle, though it is hard to predict their frequency and intensity. How does El Nino happen? In the tropical Pacific, trade winds blow from east to west. These winds push warm water to the western side of the ocean around Asia. Warm water adds extra heat to the air, which rises to create more cloud and rainfall. But in an El Nino event, trade winds weaken. Less warm water gets pushed towards the western Pacific, which causes the colder parts of the ocean to warm. Because the area of warm water moves, this changes rainfall patterns too. With fewer rain clouds, we are more likely to experience hot and dry weather in Singapore. Based on past records, we're not in for a good time. The last El Nino in 2016 was the warmest year on record in Singapore, with a mean annual temperature of 28.4 degrees Celsius. Back then, the region experienced its worst haze episode from the raging forest fires in Indonesia. Water levels in Johor's Linggu Reservoir, which supplies water to Singapore, fell to a historic low of 20%. So what can we expect this time?
If we do have a strong El Nino, it's going to be considerably hotter than it's been in the last couple of years.
We're talking about changes of 1.5 degrees or more. During El Nino periods, when we've got these drier conditions, there is that secondary effect that we're likely to have more forest fires. And that knock-on effect of that is that we could get haze events across Southeast Asia.
And we know from previous El Nino periods that considerable change in the moisture content in the atmosphere and the rainfall across the region has knock-on effects across the whole agricultural sector. So everything from rice to vegetables, even through to beef, there's knock-on effects across not only just tropical Asia, anything sourced from Australia may be affected as well.
If food stocks decline, prices will likely rise. Thankfully, Singapore is well prepared. We have diversified food sources and a sustainable water supply. We don't know how long El Nino will last, so it's important to protect ourselves during extreme weather patterns. Remember to minimize outdoor activities, stay cool, and keep yourself hydrated.